This training video is brought to you by K-Alliance. K-Alliance provides high-quality instructor-led training videos for desktop, IT, and soft skills. Visit us online at www.kalliance.com to sign up for your free 7-day trial. Be sure to like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching, and we hope you learned something new. Real learning, real videos, real success.
In this demo, we're going to be working with a multi-server environment. Now, within your Management Studio, there are a number of features that can help you manage multi-server environments. We're going to go ahead and go to our View and open up our Registered Servers pane. Now, your Registered Servers has a special feature called the Central Management Servers. This allows you to designate one server as the hub, and from that hub, I can assign groups, and each of those groups can have one or more servers associated with the group. This allows me to do things like run queries against multiple servers simultaneously. So in order to see this in action, we're going to right-click on our central management server and register a new central management server. Now for our purposes, we're going to go ahead and set up the main hub as our good old SQL 2012 server that we've been working with. We can now hit our test button to make sure that it's operating correctly, and then save it. So we now have a new centralized environment. From here, I now need to create some groups underneath it. So if I right-click, I can create a new server group. And that new server group can have a group name. We'll call it Production Servers. So we now have a new group within this management environment, and now I need to add some servers to it. So if I right-click, I can add a new server registration. Each server registration has to be to a different server instance, and you cannot have a server instance in a folder managed by itself. So when you're setting up this environment, it's common to set up your central management server as a server apart from the others, one that you're not going to interact with along with the others side by side. So we'll go ahead and we'll add in our SQL 2012 V2. We'll test it, make sure it's working, and save it. And then I'm going to add another server to this environment. So I'll do a new server registration. And this time, I'll pick my SQL 2008 R2. And that is correct. You can have servers from different versions running side by side as a part of this environment. The one thing that you have to be careful of is that any query that you write has to work for both kinds of servers. If you do something that only works in 2012, obviously, a 2008 R2 server is not going to be able to handle it. So as long as you keep that in mind, you'll be fine. So now I have both servers inside of my production environment. They are both up and running. At this point, if I want to write queries against them, I go to the folder level, and I right-click on my production server group, and I have the ability to do new queries, open up object explorers for them, evaluate policies, import policies, all sorts of fun things. We even have some basic tasks, moving, importing, and exporting. What we want to do is a new query. It opens up a new query window that is associated with the group, not an individual server. I'm going to go ahead and write in a query. It's going to be a simple one, exec sp helpdb. I want to get some information about the databases that are available across both servers. When I run this query, my results come back with a special extra column in place. That extra column is the server name. So I can see that these particular databases are associated with server 2012 V2. And if I scroll down a little further, I can see that all of these other ones are associated with my SQL 2008 R2 instance. And that's the beauty of this setup. When I run a query against the group, it will bring me back all the results and it will separate them by their server name. If there's additional information I'm interested in, there's a few options that you should be aware of. If you go under your Tools, Options, you expand out your query results, expand out your SQL Server, you'll find that there is a multi-server results option where you have three parameters that you can change. Do I want to show the login name associated with the query request? Do I want to show the server name? And do I want to merge results? Now, If you find that the query that you're running doesn't work against both servers exactly the same, their schemas don't match up, you can turn off your merge results, and that will allow it to open them in separate result panels so that they don't interfere with each other. But as long as the query results are the same for both servers, you don't have to worry about that. The login name, I added that in, and I'll rerun my query. And now we see that I have the login name as well, which in my case was the same name for both of them, so it didn't really add that much, which is one of the reasons why it's turned off by default. So with this, I hope you see how you can use your registered servers panel and your central management server tool to build and manage groups of servers that you can actually interact with as a unit.
We hope you enjoyed this preview video. Please click on the like button below if you did and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Be sure to visit us at www.kalliance.com to sign up for your free 7-day trial today. You could learn a lot in a week.